This is stuff you like, and while cool calculation does help, I'll admit, cynicism is for losers. This video is a result of a patron request for soul music, including the animated adaptation, but this is a Susan video. Make no mistake about it. The plot of Soul Music goeth thusly. Death is having an existential crisis and goes off to find himself. The hole in the world where Death is supposed to be decides that what needs to be there is Susan, Death's granddaughter. Her mother was Death's daughter by adoption. Her father was Death's ill-fated apprentice. It was a thing. There was a book about it. Susan is not happy with this, but there you are. She goes to the supposed death of Imp E. Kellen.
A Kellen. It means of the holly.
And she's about to save him. And make the same mistake her father did, but something else saves him first. The music. Hijinks ensue, and eventually there's a big concert in Hyde Park, there's a runaway cart and a steep drop, and Death threatens the music that is the backbeat of the universe, and then history rearranges itself and Susan goes back to school, and maybe Buddy slash Imp is now working in the chip shop, because we do love our elvish references.
They say he's a druid. Well, I could swear he's elvish.
Sorry, I mean our Elvis references. One of the two. And Death goes back to work. I want to say it's a plot-light Discworld book, but that's not exactly what I mean. Soul Music also to me feels oddly character development light. Don't get me wrong, I don't dislike it, but even though it's the 16th book in the Discworld series and the third Death book, it's, well, it's comforting, actually, to know that even Terry Pratchett can't land all of his concepts all of the time. The problem for me is that it's very bitty. It goes from Death to Susan to Albert to the death of rats to veterinary to the Guild of Musicians, not to mention the wizards. And while obviously it spends most of its time on Death, Susan, and Imp slash Buddy, it still feels a bit disjointed. That and the fact that Death's plot in this novel has a lot of similarities to Reaper Man means it's kind of the disjointedness is also not helped by the fact that there is some kind of possibly hinted at budding romance, see what I did there, between Imp slash Buddy and Susan, but it never really goes anywhere. When you meet Susan in the next book, we don't really speak of it ever again. Do they speak of it ever again? I mean, I know Veterinary references that music with rocks in fiasco, but does Susan ever talk about Buddy? Answers on a postcard to the usual address. The animated adaptations generally are not really my cup of tea, though they do provide very useful illustrations of points when making episodes, so they do have that going for them. And they are very, very faithful adaptations of the novels. In the Soul Music adaptation, I particularly like the Northern Irishly accented new owner of the mended drum.
Here's your $5. Can you come back tomorrow night?
He decided to go upmarket. Really, that was the only way you could go. But overall, I feel about Soul Music the same way I feel about a lot of the Rincewind books. Like, it's fun, but it doesn't quite have the punch that the later books have. It also doesn't have nearly as much Susan in it as it could have. I feel like I prefer Death in the story when he's in more of a cameo role than when he's taking up the main plot. I love Thief of Time very, very much, but it features an awful lot less Death and an awful lot more Susan. And there are fewer subplots overall, which also helps. And because it's later in the Discworld series, just by dint of practice, it's also written better. Basically, I feel like Thief of Time is a story about coming to terms with who you are and helping other people come to terms with who they are, which just happens to be really funny. Whereas Soul Music is a story about music with rocks in that just happens to have a subplot about coming of age as someone not entirely human. Hogfather is more of a Susan book than Soul Music is, but Thief of Time is where I think she really shines. I love Susan. I particularly love her lack of fear as she comes to terms with who she is. And I also love that she works with children. Her two jobs are governess and teacher. And I especially love that for all of her impatience about humanity, she's not a cynic. She's calculating and she's logical, but she doesn't give in to cynicism, and that's what I feel the later books demonstrate better than the earlier ones. She cares very deeply about people, and she does that by being sensible. Because it's her. I don't think I've ever been afraid of anything in my life, said Susan, still gulping air. Not really afraid. I get angry. I'm getting angry now, in fact. Soul Music has a girl who thinks she knows everything, discover that, as Lutze would say, there's a lot goes on that we don't know about. Hogfather lets her stretch herself as a hero, and Thief of Time is where she really, really shines. And yet, I still don't think I'd want to see it as a TV adaptation, because book pacing and TV pacing are not the same thing, and faithfulness can be deadly in an adaptation. Lack of faithfulness can also be deadly in an adaptation, but That's a whole other story. Still, I love Susan in all of her guises, because when I first read Discworld in my early 20s, Granny Weatherwax was who I wanted to be when I was older, but Susan was who I wanted to be right now. Thank you for watching this episode of Stuff You Like. If you're watching this in the first week after it goes up, I am not here. I am in the back end of Kent, hitting people with various weapons. And yes, I probably will make a video on it quite soon. If you'd like to join my patrons, either at the tier where you suggest episodes, or the tier where you can vote on them, or even at the tier where you just get early access to episodes, then you should do that, because there's probably a link over here somewhere. Or if you fancy watching more videos like this, there will also be a Discworld playlist, probably down here somewhere. All right, that's all for now, and I will see you next time. Probably with more bruises.